Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about
video name, introduction to OOPM, chapter name, object-oriented programming and procedure-oriented programming. Hi friends, today we are going to see what is object-oriented programming is all about. In last year, you might have learned some languages like C language. Okay, this particular language is one of the best example of procedure-oriented language. Okay, now in this particular chapter, we are going to learn what is object-oriented programming is all about. But before going to that, we have to learn what is procedure-oriented programming and what was a limitation it has. Okay, so let's go to procedure-oriented programming. Okay, now let's think about something called as car. Okay, now when I see a particular car, what things comes in your mind? Okay, so let's say when I'm seeing a particular car, I can see its color, I can see what model it is having, I can see what type of what features it is having, right? Now, have you ever thought how this particular car is built? No, we don't think at first time, right? That is what our human nature is all about. Whenever we see a particular thing, we think about its features and a data about it. We don't think how it works, or I will not think how it functions. Okay, that is a basic motto of object-oriented language. So let's move to the procedure-oriented. Procedure-oriented methodology is emphasizing more on functionality. That means how to do the things. Okay, so as we are a human, we are not having the tendency to go into the functionality as direct. That means I always emphasize as a human on data. That means whenever I'm seeing a particular car, I always see its features. I never see how it functions. Correct? So that was one of the drawback which procedure-oriented programming had. So procedure-oriented programming was always emphasizing on the procedures. Then what do you mean by emphasis on the procedure? Basically, let's take an example. I want to make some software. Okay, what I will do? First of all, I will gather in requirements from the particular customer, potential customer. I will have a talk with the customer. After the information is gathered about it, then what I will be doing? I will be trying to segregate those functionalities. I will try to arrange those functionalities. I will be gathering that information. I am going to divide that particular information as per the functions, and that particular functions I will be the gathered information which is there. What I will be doing? I will be finding out what exactly I need to do out of those requirements. Okay, then that means I'm going to identify actual functionality. Once I will be identifying this particular functionality, then I'm going to arrange those functionalities. Once this arrangement has been done, then I'm going to find it out what data is actually I require to get those functionality done. Once it has been done, then I'm going to start actual coding. And once this coding is being done, then I will be performing the testing. And once this testing is being done, then I will be handovering this particular thing to the user. Now, user will use it and it will give me user acceptance. That's what the procedure follows in the procedure oriented programming. Okay, now what's wrong in this particular thing? Okay, first of all, as a human being, I'm not having ability to identify exact functionality, because as I told, human is having a tendency to identify data first rather than the functionality. That is a very very much needed in nowadays. So If I say procedure-oriented programming, it is emphasizing more on the procedures, okay, rather than the data. Then this particular approach, if I say it is starting from top as a function and then it goes around to the data. So it is following top to bottom approach. Okay, now the best example I can give for that is a C language. In C language, you write everything in terms of functions. After that, you just write a line of a code to perform the task. Once that this task, whenever we are actually thinking about this task, it's very much what I can say, complex. Okay, which is that is why we have got another approach, another methodology, and that is nothing but object oriented programming. So let's first of all see what limitations which we have already discussed in procedure oriented language. So first of all, it is focusing more on the procedures. Translation to the of the requirements, user's requirement, to the actual system design is a bit difficult in procedure oriented language. Risk of data security. Now, what do you mean by that? What I can say is, when I'm making up functions, there is a communication possible between two functions, and that happens by sharing the data. Okay, now whenever I'm sharing a data from one function to another function, the data can be global, and such global data can be modified or can be misused during the communication, which gives me lack of security. That is one of the reason why we are in recent days we are not using procedure oriented programming. Then there is a difficulty in debug. Now I may find that there is a problem in one function, but as a system itself consists of n number of functions, I need to identify where actually this particular problem is actually rely. So I need to identify that. So debugging is kind of a thing which is difficult in procedure oriented programming. Last thing, it's a reusability. Now if I'm making any product, it should be extensible, it should be reusable. If I'm making any function, any module in my software, I want that same particular portion I can reuse somewhere else. So that particular extension is not that possible in procedure oriented programming. And that's why we are moving to the next thing, that is object oriented programming. So let's see first of all what are the features we are having in object oriented programming. So first of all, object oriented programming is emphasizing more on the real things which we are calling as an object. Okay, so real world entity can be mapped to the system design. Basically, as I'm again, I can give another example for the same. Let's say I have a fan in my room. Now, when I'm seeing a particular fan in the room, what features comes in my mind? So basically, it's color, right? It's design, right? Which company it belongs to, and how much speed it can give me. These are the things which comes in my mind, right? So I can say a fan as an object, I can identify, I can actually relate my thoughts to that particular object, right? So that is a human tendency to emphasize more on the data rather than procedures, okay? Then modular. Now, what do you mean by modularity? We will be discussing this further, but I can say that a complex system is divided into small parts. Okay, like for example, if I'm having a fan, it is not get built as a whole system. Basically, first, if I want to make a fan, I have to first make the flips. I need to make the internal engines of that particular fan. Then I will be joining them together, and that makes fan as an object, right? So breaking the system into small part is nothing but a modularity. Then reusability and extension. Okay, now as new technologies emerging, new things we need to add in our existing system. So we have to make our system in a such a way so that it can be, I can say it can allow me to add a new features into it, as well as it can allow me to have a reusability. That means some portion of my program I can use somewhere else also. So object-oriented programming allows me to do so. Then easy to debug. As we are having some kind of a abstraction in the object. Now, what is abstraction? We will learn a bit later. So, I can say that whenever I'm having an object, object is nothing but anything which in this particular world which is having certain name. Okay. So, if I'm saying that I can identify everything in terms of object, I will be concentrating on object and I can able to debug that particular object whenever required. Okay, so that's why I can say it is easy to debug, right? Then there is a security concern. Now, in object-oriented programming, we are having certain features which allow me to hide the data, okay, when I'm from the external world or from external modules. That makes it more secure. These are all points we will see in detail in the next section.